Yo, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to another Madden 22 online CFM game. We are now in week 17 of the 2021 NFL season here in the Premier Madden League. Normally, week 17 means the regular season finale, but of course, we have week 18 going on now, so this is the penultimate game of our regular season and most likely our season in general. So the Chargers are the 7th seed right now. They have 9 wins after defeating us. If we win both of our games to close out the season, we'll be at 9, but not at the number that we probably need to be in wildcard contention, which is 10. So I'm considering us pretty much mathematically eliminated from the playoffs at this point. So what does that leave us for the last 2 weeks of the regular season? We're just going to kick it. Have some fun. Now, on the stark contrast, despite entering this game with a 6-9 record, the San Francisco 49ers enter this game controlling their own destiny. That is the contrast between the AFC and NFC, where the 49ers can win their last two games, go 8-9, and make the playoffs as the 7th seed in the NFC conference. So we'll be playing a 49ers team that's determined and ready to go. Meanwhile, as we are underway, our Houston Texans have a treat to unveil today. We have a new starting quarterback for the second week in a row. It's not Davis Mills. It's not Tyrod Taylor. It's Tim Tebow. You know what? I told you guys, we're gonna have some fun. And why not let Tim Tebow have one last hoorah in the NFL? Let's give it a go and see what Tebow can do, what Tebow magic is all about. Tebow got driven out the league, fairly, unfairly. Was he trash? Probably. Or was he not? We'll find out today. We're going to give Tebow a chance. He's 32 years old, but why not let him kick it one last time? And we're going to get Tebow on the field here, our starting quarterback today. We're going to be at our own 15-yard line after the penalty, though. And here's Tebow dropping back the pass, and he's picked off on his first play. He throws a touchdown, but to the defense. Tim Tebow, SMH, not the way we want to start off today. Defense got a nice stop, but it's all for naught as the 49ers score a touchdown in under 90 seconds. But if there's any good news, we started off our last game against the Chargers by getting a quick pick six and still losing. So maybe we can use the reverse formula as Tim Tebow on that read option. We're going to let Tebow do a little bit of everything as Deontay Foreman is actually getting some carries here. We just picked up Deontay Foreman out of free agency, and we're going to give him a go. Why not? I think we can give Adrian Peterson a little bit of a rest. I mean, this might be the last couple of games of Adrian Peterson's career, but as we get a nice play here to Nico Collins and Tebow leading a nice drive with this offense. But yeah, we're going to give, you know, Adrian Peterson a little bit of a rest and let Tim Tebow carry the heavy load on this offense. Oh, Tebow all the way to the 2-yard line. Next play, Tebow. Whoa, it is Tebow time here in Santa Clara as we are knotted up after the PAT, and you can see some recipes of things we have not done with this offense all season long. You know, a run scheme designed around our quarterback with Davis Mills, we couldn't quite do that. Even Tyrod Taylor might be a little too fragile to run those plays, but with Tebow, you know, why not? And once again, this goes to us experimenting for next season as well, trying to find a quarterback fit for us. As Tremont Smith gets hurt there, he already has a penalty to his name. They're adding injury to insult at the moment. 3rd and 5, Trey Lance on the move. He's got him. It's Trey Sermon out the backfield. And on the broken play, Trey Sermon all the way to about the 34-yard line. And there's that second act that has been a thorn in our side for this Texans defense. We can't get that quick pass rush. Teams definitely have all day against us. We're doing a decent job defending the rushing attack of the 49ers, which I was worried about entering this game as Trey Lance, middle of the field, gonna get it to Sermon, but that will not be a first down. Nice tackle by Roquan Smith. Also a nice catch by Sermon. So here's a 4th and 1, and the 49ers are gonna go no huddle here, and we're gonna call a timeout. Just like last week, 4th and 1, someone went no huddle on 4th down. We're gonna call a timeout. Didn't really work for us last time, so let's see how it does this time around. They'll drop back the pass here with Lance quickly out the backfield. George Kittle getting separation from Grugier Hill, and maybe we should just let them go no huddle on 4th down, because that might just be a frustration thing, I suppose. But yeah, we call a timeout. It seems like they come out in a play they really want more so than we do. We're gonna try to get a defensive stand here though. 3rd down and goal at the 9-yard line. Lance in trouble, breaks away from the initial initial hit, but is eventually brought down. And I believe it was Jenkins there that got the initial hit. Blacklock cleaning up the mess, and the 49ers end up settling for the field goal. So, yeah, I mean, back to what I was saying here on the offensive side, you know, we're experimenting all different ways. And Tebow, he's not really going to show us a lot. He's going to show us how bad of an arm he has, and once again, how badly we need a quarterback that can make throws outside the numbers. And we're going to need to make better reads than that, no matter who the quarterback is. Picked off by Williams, and Tim Tebow already has two INTs as we wrap up the first quarter. Lance doing his dance. Got him open. It's Brandon Ayuk turning away for the touchdown. And in one play, the 49ers cash in on the Tebow INT. So, yeah, I mean, we're just having fun right now, man. These games literally have no pressure, and to be completely honest with you guys, it is in our best interest to lose our last two games of the regular season. Are we going to lose our last two? Are we going to make it happen? Not exactly, but we are starting Tim Tebow, so 110% has been completely thrown out the window. In that Chargers game, you know, we still had a mathematical chance, so we were still going to try to make it happen as Deontay Foreman making it happen here on the shovel option. But yeah, this game, there's really nothing to play for as far as playoffs. There's no incentive to win the game. So, I mean, the 49ers, like I said, they have all the incentive right now. They're playing this like, you know, their butts are on fire. Meanwhile, for us, you know, we're just vibing, having fun. You know, let's see how far Tebow can take us, win or loss. We're just here to play with Tim Tebow for perhaps one last time as Deontay Foreman. How about the job Deontay Foreman has done fresh off the streets? I'm actually pretty impressed with what Foreman's doing for us. You might have to invest in Deontay Foreman for next year. Not as like the number one back, but someone to have around. This guy, like, he brings that Adrian Peterson rough running that we've been enjoying so far this season, except he's younger. Obviously, Foreman's doing a decent job in real life with the Tennessee Titans with the Derrick Henry injury, and he's doing decent for our Houston Texans right now as he scores the touchdown. Foreman cutting the grass here at Levi's Stadium and getting into the end zone. Deontay Foreman making a name for himself in full-blown experimentation mode doesn't mean that we're sabotaging the team. We might actually be finding out things that work for us right here, right now, on the spot. And once again, a solid drive being led by this Tebow offense. I believe that's going to be a free play for the 49ers, and they're probably going to decline the penalty as Trey Sermon gets a solid run here, and that's going to be offsides on Jacob Martin. Shades of Chase Winovich in our Patriots franchise as they go with the RPO here on first down. Look at the closing speed there by Kevin Pierre-Lewis. A lot of these guys on our team, like Kevin Pierre-Lewis, probably not going to be back next season. So, you know, I mean, Kevin Pierre-Lewis not playing great coverage, but it doesn't really matter to us because he's probably not going to be back. Desmond King is a guy, as Trey Sermon gets the first down, that is still an impending free agent. We have not offered Desmond King a contract yet, as Trey Lance able to connect their first down to bunting the tight end. But yeah, Desmond King is a guy that I'm not really too interested in bringing back because our salary cap for next season is not going to be in the best shape, not as in good a shape as you would expect for a Houston Texans team with zero talent. Because if you guys remember, the Deshaun Watson trade that we pulled off, that trade has ramifications for next season where we are going to be hit with a $51 million cap penalty as Trey Lance running like a chicken with no head. Down he goes. Zach Cunningham will be credited with the sack. And on 3rd and 12, they just kind of waved the white flag, running with Sermon there, hoping for a home run. We call our final timeout of the half right there to try to get the ball back for Tebow and this offense with about 2 minutes to work. But yeah, we're going to get a $51 million cap hit next season, cap penalty, for trading Deshaun Watson while he was on his mega deal. Because remember, he had just signed a new 4-year deal in real life before sitting out this season, or an extension. It was just recently signed, so that is something to keep in mind as we are going to drop back here with Tim Tebow on first now. For now, focusing on this game, but it's not going well for us. It's going to be a pick, and Tebow whiffs. It'll be a pick six, the second one of the game. 49ers have not really found the end zone on their own merit. It's really our turnovers that are gifting them their touchdowns. But hey, man, like I said, losing is not the worst thing in the world. So am I mad about what's going on? Nah. I mean, am I happy about the way this game is going? Not exactly, because these are my own mistakes, right? Like, it's not really a lot of Tebow, but it's more so me than Tebow. But yeah, that's what's going on right now with our squad is Deontay Foreman making moves. So as far as making moves in the offseason, you know, we can't exactly just go from night to day and transform this team. We're going to have to go move very strategically in the offseason as we bomb it accidentally downfield for Christian Kirk. I hit the wrong button there. I tried to go to Square, who was running that slant over the top. Looked like he would get open. Instead, I threw it to Christian Kirk downfield, and I believe that's going to be Christian Kirk's last play of the game. Very similar to what happened last week. Christian Kirk has decided to pull an Antonio Brown, and that's the last you're going to see of him for this game. I don't think he's going to be returning for the second half. So we're going to be down by 13 and without Christian Kirk for the second consecutive second half in a row. It's the progressive fatigue of the season that I believe is starting to get to Christian Kirk. We got him a lot of footballs, but we really wore him out in that Chargers game. He was already a little tired entering that game, and I did a full pad practice. So I think all of that accumulated to Christian Kirk's wear and tear getting really high. So that's a lesson learned. I was not doing full pad practices all season long until last week against the Chargers, and I did one and Christian Kirk is suddenly dead tired. So yeah, maybe we don't do full pad practices next season, but one thing we will do right now is the halftime show. Welcome to the halftime show, where today's game of the week takes place between the upset-minded New York Giants and the Hungry Bears, looking for a win to pursue a wild card berth. But the New York Giants owning the Bears' first-round pick in the upcoming draft know it's in their best interest to win this game and see if they can force the Bears to miss the playoffs. So far, so good. The 3-win Giants playing their best football of the season with something on the line, just a little bit of something. But of course, the Bears have a whole lot of something, so they're not going to go away quietly. That's Darnell Mooney on fourth down, big play. Damir Bird flies in for six. To the fourth quarter we go. Bears trailing by a touchdown, and the touchdown they shall get from Darnell Mooney, traveling to the sunny side, and we're all knotted up at Soldier Field. But the Giants on the next drive, calm as a cucumber. It's Daniel Jones up the middle, and after a Bears turnover, it's time to book this one. Oh my goodness, the Giants with the big win to shake up the wild card positioning in the NFC Conference. Now we go to the rest of the league action! Speaking of getting shaken up, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers shell-shocked at MetLife as the New York Jets poured it on and simply did not put their foot off the gas pedal. My, it's Moreau literally flying in. J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets. Meanwhile, Tampa Bay in a very dire position for their playoff pursuit. The Jacksonville Jaguars going against Problem, and the Patriots ran into, well, a little bit of a problem. And that was the downfield passing of Mac Jones. And the Jaguars are put in a must-win situation in Week 18. Oh, down goes Tua Tagovailoa. A battle of two 10-5 teams battling for wildcard positioning in the AFC Conference. And the Tennessee Titans absolutely dominated. Oh, no. Derrick Henry's lit up. That's ball game. The Tennessee Titans absolutely dominate in Nashville. We move on to a big battle in Washington, where the Washington football team needs a win to lock up the NFC East Division, going against the rival Eagles up the middle. Antonio Gibson cannot be brought down, and Washington early and often putting points on the board. The NFC East is theirs. Oh, we have a fake field goal in an insignificant battle in the AFC North. Austin Hooper, look at him go! For the touchdown, a dazzling play by the Cleveland Browns, but it all went up in smoke as Baker Mayfield trying to do a little bit too much. Yeah, that's the recipe for a disaster, and that'll be a big Steelers victory. Steelers winning three games in a row now, as we have Denard with the interception, and the Dallas Cowboys put in an awkward position against the one-win Arizona Cardinals, but they will stay the one-win Arizona Cardinals. Dalton Schultz shaking them out of his shoes. Cowboys with the victory. Moving on to a battle in Baltimore between the Rams and the Ravens. The Ravens already have their division locked up, so Tyler Huntley in the game, and Tyler Huntley, the game-losing safety. What a way to drop it. Rams get the win. As we move on to Jameis Winston, just put it up there and pray. Allen Robinson is somewhere, and the Saints in a pursuit for a division win, a wild card berth. Anything's on the table for the Saints going into the final week of the regular season. After that victory, Denver with the big dub. That'll clinch the AFC West in their favor. Chargers needing a win in the final weekend. Finally, the Bills pour it on, and that'll get them the AFC East division. And we are back to start the second half. We are down by 13, but we will be getting the ball. And hopefully we'll not be turning it over on this drive. When we've actually been able to put together drives, they have been working out pretty decently, even with this Tebow-led offense and the way we're running it. But it's also the way we're running this scheme that's actually helping us. It's just, we can't throw the ball too much. Oh, man, and even when we try, this 49ers pass rush dials it up a whole nother level. Bosa's going to get the sack. A couple of guys came in free there. Third down and 16. Yeah. All right. So I think we know that it was not the NFL that blackballed Tebow out the league completely why Tim Tebow is not a quarterback anymore. That was definitely a missed opportunity. I had a tight window to get it into. Would have been 100% chance of the catch, but we gave ourselves a 0% chance by not throwing it accurately. So we punt the ball away here. Lance and the 49ers on second down. Going to go underneath to Elijah Mitchell and Roquan Smith making that open field tackle. So it's going to be a third down here. 49ers put a man in motion. That's Ayoub. Lance going to go middle of the field, and it's caught. That is George Kittle, who somehow got the ball with Justin Reed all over him. And I don't really know what that play was all about, but we'll just move on and watch Lance go crossbody to Jalen Hurd. They'll call it a touchdown. Footwork was a little sketchy, but the boot doesn't even review it. They'll just call it a quick six right there, and the 49ers are suddenly up big in this one. So, I mean, yeah, even plays like that where Justin Reed probably should have at least gotten a swat right there. I tried to go for a swat, didn't work. It's whatever, man. This game doesn't really matter at the end of the day, and we're in a better position by losing this game than by winning it. As we throw an incompletion there, Tim Tebow at the Wildcat didn't quite work out for us. Deontay Foreman, this has been the low-key MVP of the team today. And, I mean, it's easy to run around in open space, but Deontay Foreman, man, I don't know. There's something about him that I like that really makes me want to bring him back next season and at least test him out next week. As Nick Bosa with the recovery. Nick Bosa out of gas. Foreman makes the tackle. The fumble by Tebow. Not a good look. That is turnover number 5 of the game, I believe, for Tebow. 4 or 5. Not great, as Roquan making the touchdown saving tackle on the next play. That's Lance. Got him. It's Juszczyk. Touchdown 49ers. And this is a blowout. So the thing is, if we lose our last two games of the season, there's a chance we can get our draft pick to move maybe 5 or 6 spots. Like, it could be that drastic if we lose these last two games. So, I mean, it's the difference between picking, pick 16 or 17 to maybe, pick 12. And, I mean, that's good for our Texans squad. Because, remember, we have 3 first-round draft picks this year. We have the 5-10 Philadelphia Eagles draft pick. And that's looking like it's going to be a top 10 pick. If not, maybe even a top 5 pick. And then we have the Miami Dolphins pick. It looks like Miami's going to make the playoffs. But as you guys saw on the halftime show, they did lose last week. So, you know, there's still a window open for them to lose, and that could be pick 17 or 18. So, you know, there's a chance we have, 3 pretty solid picks going into the draft. And, our best interest is dropping this pick down, but are we trying to lose this game? No. In fact, we have benched Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow, we've seen enough of the man. Down he goes, and in comes Tyrod Taylor on 3rd, down and 4. Tyrod got a touchdown. Welcome back, Tyrod Taylor. It's Ty God time. And, I mean, we had enough of Tebow, man. There was the awkward plays. I was not running my play actions to the left side. And I had enough of Tebow, to be quite frank, man. We got our Tebow experience, and we're getting killed. Let's just put Tyrod in the game and see what happens. And, I mean, so far, so good. Tyrod got a quick touchdown. That's what you like to see. If we want to have any chance of making some crazy comeback. I mean, we expect the 49ers to really put this in park the bus mode here. They're up big. They know they need this game to stay alive in their somewhat odd playoff pursuit, even though they're 6-9 entering this game. 3rd and 2, they're going to run the pitch here with Elijah Mitchell, and that's going to be Zach Cunningham taking him down. So a quick 3 and out for the 49ers. They needed to, park the bus, put it in shoot clock mode, run the ball. They ran the ball, but they did not get the first down, and they give it right back to Tyrod Taylor. So let's see if Tyrod can avoid the turnovers that kept taking down Tim Tebow and our offense in the first half, mainly in this game. Tyrod never stood a chance on that one. Epukam off the edge going against our backup right tackle. The offensive line struggled last week, and they're struggling again. We got a couple of backups in there. We have a couple of season-ending injuries. Now it's 4th down and 17. Might as well go for it here. Tyrod with a floater. He's got Nico Collins. Down they go, and Nico's got the juice to go. 70. 36 yards. We needed 17. We got it all on that play. Somehow, some way, and suddenly, after the PAT, it is a 13-point game. This is a very winnable game. And why not? Let's go for it. The story of making this comeback would be pretty fun, right? I don't know how many points we were down. It was a whole lot. I mean, what was it, 29? We were down a whole darn lot, 27, I don't know. But as we get the stop here, Kevin Pierre-Lewis on the sack after the lag. Jimmy Garoppolo in the game on third down and 13. Garoppolo underneath. Elijah Mitchell trying to fight, will not get the first down. And on fourth and two, 49ers put Wisnowski on the field to punt the ball away to a Texans offense that has scored two straight touchdowns. It's been a little awkward, but we have scored two straight touchdowns. And DeAndre Foreman cannot be tackled. Look at this little bulldozer. Or little big bulldozer. That man's like 6'3", 230 pounds. That guy is a force in the open field. I'm loving Deontay Foreman, it must be said. Deontay Foreman, we just signed him. He's like a 67 overall, but he's playing like the best running back we've had on this roster all season long. That includes AP, that includes Lindsey, that includes David Johnson, anybody that we played this year. As we throw it to the fake Andre Johnson. Once again, my apologies about that, but that number is not getting changed. This season's already been played as we throw that ball away. Shout out to the refs for letting that one go. No intentional grounding. Play on. 5:57 left. 3rd and 5. Obvious 4-down territory all around town as we get it to Gary Jennings. And that's the same play, the same throw that Tebow missed that Tyrod is able to make. Oh, man. But just like Tebow, Tyrod picked off by Jaquiski Tartt. And Tartt, he's got a convoy of blockers. If he can make it work, down goes one. Oh, man. A block in the back on the next one. Chris Conley still trying to give it an effort. Tartt low on stamina, but into the end zone he goes. Jaquiski Tartt, what a game he's had. Two pick sixes on the day, and that one should stymize a late Houston Texans comeback. We were knocking on the door of making a one possession game with 5 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Would have been plenty of time, but got a little bit too greedy trying to put that one in the end zone. Maybe a little too locked in on Nico Collins just with how well Nico has been playing. But for the second week in a row, it's interesting to see that when Christian Kirk decides to pull an AB on us, that Nico Collins steps up. And it's a little weird. I'm not sure I'm completely happy about it, as Collins yet again laterals the ball to Jennings. Oh, yeah, that nearly worked. That nearly worked all the way as we get a little bit of lag here. And, yeah, the lag definitely messed me up there. I don't know what happened there, but I'm just going to say that the lag messed it up. That did not look too fluid. And as we throw the interception, and that's pretty much going to kill our chances. But, yeah, I'm not sure what to make out of the fact that Nico Collins steps up when our number one guy, whether it's Christian Kirk or Brandon Cooks, our number 13 wide receiver, is not on the field. I also don't know what to do about this Christian Kirk situation. The same thing is probably going to happen next week. We'll just have to play him until Christian Kirk decides he doesn't want to play anymore. We could put him on a pitch count, but like, I don't know what the pitch count is. Just use him in certain formations. It doesn't really matter to me. That was 100% the wrong button right there. I tried to throw it downfield to Gary Jennings. And yeah, this game is all sorts of tripped up right now. I've been throwing wrong buttons multiple times. Just not locked into this one, but it's all good, man. Well, you know, GG's to the 49ers, man. We didn't give them this game. They had to earn it. And they definitely earned it, especially on the defensive side of the ball, just creating turnovers left and right. Late on the throw right there, and that's going to cost us the first down as we hit the two-minute warning. So fourth down, a little heavy panther here. Tyrod Taylor is still the quarterback, and trying to do too much at the line of scrimmage, I suppose. So they're going to call that a false start. And instead of getting a first down, we had a fourth down and one, and now we have a fourth down and six. We're going to go back to the same play that worked for a touchdown last time we had a fourth down and long. And this time, Tyrod breaking the pocket with some space. Oh, man, Tyrod, what are you doing, my guy? I'll tell you exactly what Tyrod did right there. I just hit circle to just bomb it downfield. And I hit circle after I passed the line of scrimmage, and Dustin put me in a spin move instead of a throw. So, yeah, it was definitely not the most locked-in game we've ever played, but it's all good, man. Like I said, we're just having some fun, evaluating our roster. And I feel like check and check. Tebow didn't play well. It wasn't fun when Tebow was throwing picks, but still, check and check. GG's to the 49ers, man. Like I said, we didn't give it to the 49ers. They had to earn it. So, I mean, I'm not going to take away any credit from what they did. We'll see if they can make the playoffs as an 8-9 team. Obviously, we were in that NFC conference. I mean, it'd be a whole nother story. We got the Houston Texans in the top-heavy AFC. We were just not dealt the greatest hand and in the toughest division in the entire league. Not the best hand to be dealt with, but hey, man, it's all good. We're not going to make the playoffs this year, but you know, we'll try to bounce back next year. And in the meantime, you know, at the end of the day, we're enjoying it and also enjoying the grind of rebuilding this Texans team. Because I say it every once in a while to you guys, I probably enjoy the team building aspect of these CFMs more than actually playing the games. So I'm looking forward to seeing what we could do with this Texans team in the offseason, see what kind of moves we can swing and what we can do with all these draft picks we got, man. So on that note, leave a like if you guys enjoyed what you guys saw today. Subscribe for more Madden 22 gameplays, especially if you like this franchise stuff. And I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you, as always, for watching.